Hello everyone and welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and you can also join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information regarding the daily sessions and also about the courses. So let's begin with the very first question, which says how much subsistence allowance is being given to the transgender person in view of COVID-19 pandemic by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment headed by Mr. Thavarchand Gehlot, and you all know that he is the leader in Rajya Sabha also. So the news is that the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment will give transgender persons a one-time financial assistance of rupees 1500 in the wake of COVID-19, and this will be given to meet their basic requirements. The transgender's basic requirements ko pura karne ke liye 1500 rupees diye jayenge by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. And remember, any transgender person or community-based organization on behalf of the transgender person can apply for this financial assistance with the help of any basic details like Aadhaar card and bank account number. Alright. Now, these are some other steps that have been taken by the government to uplift the position of transgenders in our country. Like, the ministry provided similar financial assistance in the last year's lockdown also to the transgender person. A total amount of 98.50 lakh rupees was incurred last year, which benefited nearly 7,000 transgender persons across the country. And also, there was also a free helpline that was launched for the distressed transgender person for their psychosocial support and mental health care. Okay. So there are various steps that have been taken by the government to uplift the position, uplift the situations of the transgender persons. Alright. So this was about this news, and the question is how much subsistence allowance is being given. So it's rupees 1500. So option A will be the correct answer. And remember, this is a one-time financial assistance. Aisa nahi hai ki 2-3 mahine ya 4 mahine ke liye diya jayega. This is just for the, this is just a one-time financial assistance. Okay. And now let's move ahead to question number 2. The ICMR approved India's first self-use rapid antigen test kit for COVID-19, which is named as CoviSelf. The question is, which organization has developed this kit? So remember, ICMR has approved this self-use kit, which is known as CoviSelf, for rapid antigen test for COVID-19. And it has been developed by My Lab Discovery Solutions. My Lab Discovery Solution, which is a Pune-based company which deals with this molecular biology. And this kit uses a rapid antigen test and gives results within 15 minutes. 15 minutes mein aapko aapka result mil jayega. And it is synced with a mobile app which is known as CoviSelf. And it will directly feed the positive cases of COVID-19 to the ICMR portal. This app ke through ICMR portal ke paas jankari chali jayegi, jisse government ke paas data hoga about any persons who has been diagnosed as COVID-19 positive. Okay. And this test, guys, can be purchased for rupees 250 without any prescription from local pharmacies, and it should be only used on the symptomatic individuals and on the immediate contacts of laboratory confirmed positive cases. Okay, so basically symptomatic individuals ko hi isko use karna chahiye, because iska jo agar har koi iska istemal karne lagega to definitely iska jo demand hai wo badh jayega, supply kam ho jayegi, to wo symptomatic individuals usko use nahi kar payenge. Okay. So here the correct answer should be My Lab Discovery Solutions. Option C will be the correct answer, because this organization has developed this kit which is known as CoviSelf. And now let's move ahead to question number 3, which is about India-Israel cooperation in agriculture. So you have to consider the following statements regarding the work program that has been signed between the India and Israel for cooperation in agriculture, and you have to find the correct statements. So let's talk about this. So India and Israel have signed a 3-year joint work program for year 2021-23. And they are implementing this Indo-Israel Agricultural Project Centers of Excellence and Indo-Israel Villages of Excellence. So there are two projects under this joint work program, which is Indo-Israel Agricultural Project Center of Excellence and Indo-Israel Villages of Excellence. And remember, this was the 5th Indo-Israel Agricultural Action Plan. Isse pehle 4 complete ho chuke hain. Alright. Now talking about the Indo-Israel Agricultural Project Centers of Excellence, so Mission of Integrated Development and Horticulture, which is under the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, and MASHAV. MASHAV, guys, is an acronym in the Hebrew language, so that is not important for us. It is an Israel's agency for international development cooperation, These two bodies, these two missions are the operational agencies for this project center of excellence. And they will implement advanced intensive agricultural farms with Israel Agri technology tailored to the local conditions. Advanced intensive agricultural farm को implement किया जाएगा जिसमें Israeli agro technology का इस्तेमाल किया जाएगा and they are the leading which Mashab. Are the leading Israel's largest G2G cooperation with 29 operational centers of excellence across India in the 12 states already. Okay. And talking about Indo-Israel villages of excellence, so this is a new concept aimed at creating a model ecosystem in agricultural sector. Ek model ecosystem banaya jayega in agricultural sector in 75 villages across 8 states. And this program, guys, will focus on modern agriculture, infrastructure, capacity building and market linkage. So this is about these two projects and now let's come back to the question. So you have to find the correct statement. So it is a 3-year joint work program for 2021 to 23. This is absolutely correct. It includes Indo-Israel Agricultural Project Center of Excellence. This is also correct. It includes Indo-Israel Villages of Excellence. That is also correct. It will be implemented in 75 villages across 8 states. And this is the 4th Indo-Israel Agricultural Action Plan. No, that is the 5th. Okay, so this is the 5th Indo-Israel Agricultural Action Plan. Before this, 4 plans have already been implemented. So here the correct answer should be white option B, 1, 2 and 3. Okay. And now let's move ahead to question number 4. Question number 4 is about a partnership between TRIFED and DASH, which is for implementing the Vandhan initiative in tribal clusters of all the aspirational districts of India. So aspirational district ka naam सुनते ही आपके दिमाग में चमकना चाहिए दैट द आंसर शुड बी नीति आयोग बिकॉज एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स के जो भी करता धरता है दैट इज नीति आयोग ओनली सो इट्स द नीति आयोग एंड ट्राइफेड विच हैव पार्टनर्ड फॉर इंप्लीमेंटिंग द वंदन इनिशिएटिव इन ट्राइबल क्लस्टर्स ऑफ ऑल द एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स इन इंडिया बेसिकली दीज एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट विल बी दोज विच आर द ट्राइबल एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स राइट सो वंदन योजना गाइज विल बी इंप्लीमेंटेड इन ईच ऑफ द 39 ट्राइबल एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स एज आई टोल्ड यू And the special focus will be on these aspirational districts where the tribal population is more than 50%. Zyada focus kahan pe hoga? Jahan pe tribal population 50% se zyada hai. And remember, this partnership is expected to give a boost to the employment generation to nearly 2 lakh tribal families in these tribal aspirational districts where this Vandhan initiative will be implemented in future. Okay. So, therefore, the correct answer is what option D, Niti Aayog. And now, let's move ahead to question number 5, which is about the cyclone Taukte. I know you all know about this cyclone, but hum isliye pad rahe hain because government ne ab iske jo impact hai uske bare mein bhi jankari de di hai. The government has released the information about the impact also. That is why we are studying this right now. And ek aur tufaan aap logon ne dekha hoga, Yaas karke aa chuka hai. So India suffered extremely severe cyclonic storm of 2021 Taukte during 13th May to 19th May 2021. Question is which of the following is not one of the states being affected by this? कौन सा state इनमें से affect नहीं हुआ था? तो if you remember, this cyclone hit the eastern coast. ये eastern coast में आया था, basically Arabian Sea में आया था ये. And ये जो cyclone Yaas है, it has been originated in Bay of Bengal. Okay, so it will impact the West Bengal, the Odisha, and the other states which are on the western coast of our country. Okay, so the question is which of the following is not one of the states? So let's talk about this. And remember this Taukte. This Taukte name is given by Myanmar. And the Taukte means gecko, which is a distinctively vocal lizard in the Burmese language. ठीक है Taukte का मतलब क्या होता है एक distinctively vocal lizard मतलब basically एक छिपकली होता है in the Burmese language. Okay, and it originated from a tropical disturbance which was first monitored by IMD on 13th May and on 19th May it weakened into a well-marked low pressure area. And these are the states that were affected by this cyclone. Kerala, Lakshadweep, Goa, Karnataka, Maharashtra and Gujarat. All eastern coast states. And these are the impacts that have been provided by the government. It resulted in at least 169 deaths in India and left another 81 people missing. And it displaced over 2 lakh people in Gujarat. That is a huge number. And the losses are estimated around rupees 15,000 crores. 15,000 crore ke nuksan ka anuman lagaya hai Bharat Sarkar ne due to this cyclone. Okay. So now let's come back to the question. Kaun sa state nahi hai? So the correct answer should be option A, Odisha. Odisha of course इसका आंसर होगा बिकॉज इट इज ऑन द वेस्टर्न कोस्ट ऑफ आर कंट्री. सो ऑप्शन ए हेयर इज द करेक्ट आंसर. राइट एंड गाइज दैट्स इट फॉर द सेशन. आई होप ऑल द क्वेश्चंस आर क्लियर. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. मिलते हैं फ्राइडे के सेशन में. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.